Hello, I'm Mr. Arnachan, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And this knowledge of gospel, as Jesus has stated, it cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart. So this is done through logical reasoning. Logical reasoning brews logo, and logo is his word. So his word, gospel, get written over your heart and not in ink on paper. So gospel get written over your heart by our Father. If your temple of God is clean of mammon, if you have attraction of mammon, then God is out and mammon is in. It will create destruction. That's why Jesus and his apostles are his brethren took to wilderness of the order of Melchizedek sadhus, who have nothing to do with the worldly attraction. And the first church, when it was formed, people sold their possessions and entered the community of the first church, in which that was onefold Church of God, headed by one shepherd, Christ Jesus. So when the Messianic Jews, they took it over, they bring in their temple practices as much as they could. But when they enter the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, then they bring almost all the practices of the temple. So in Islam, of this Sharia, in Mullah Islam, we have Sharia and circumcision. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac, and only the people of Semitic race, sons of Isaac, can have circumcision, nobody else. I lived in Ghana, over there are people of certain tribes, they have tribal mark on their faces. From looking at the person, you can tell this man belongs to this tribe or that tribe. So they have identification. So the tribes or kabilas are made for identification in Adam. So you become sons of man, bande de putta. So then only you can be sons of God. If you are not sons of man but son of Satan, then you are going on the wrong direction. So to make the people sons of man, Hazrat Abraham, he created this Hajirites, which are like this, in which you repulse three types of Satan, which is Al-Jamar al-Dunya, they are mustard seed, the bastard born of the prostitutes and the temple priest, temple dancing girls. They could become saint, as Saint Vidyar was, and Krishna stayed with Saint Vidyar instead of staying in the palace to listen to his sermon. And here is the one which are born in the tribal homes. They have the father, secular tribal father, but they do go to a rich country and to adopt themselves into that rich country so that they can have money, cheat people. They take on the surname which are Arabicized, like Jaffrey and Sari and all that. But in their secretly they keep their family tree intact. When there's marriage or something, then they look at each other's So this is more, this become changes a tribal identity for the sake of money. So he is self-made bastard, which we call super bastard. Then we have this third one, is the one which is leaning against the hillock. Satan is leaning against the hillock, and that hillock is of phonetics. Phonetics are two types, which is non-religious, which are called Al-Jamaat Al-Kubra, like Congress and Green Party, Labour Party, Conservative, all those parties. They have nothing to do with the tribal people. And then here you are, when they take the religious color, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, etc. And this is called Al-Jamaat Al-Aqsa. Very powerful Satan, and that kills many people. So there is this two page, and you can have copy of this one in the description of the YouTube parable. You can make it and you can study it. It's up to you. So the gospel you get is through logical reasoning, which you have to do it over your own heart. And when you do it, then you get gospel treasures, which is Al-Kitab, the book of Allah. And this book cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart. So you can't, you have to explain the thing to a person from the very basic, as you have understood it. And then you make him the son of the Most High God, Allah, Parbrahm, and Elohim, same thing. So these sons are spiritual and not the physical sons. What apply to physical world, the opposite apply to the spiritual. In physical world, you have mother and father and relative, you know, which are separate entities. In spiritual world, you have father, God, mother is Holy Spirit, and son, which represents father, and they are in one entity. They are not separate, they are one entity. That is, St. Thomas said, you know, first you are two. First you are one, in one with our Father. Our soul was with our Father. And then you became two, Father and soul separated. And with their soul takes this form inside here. And after you have become two, what will you do? And that a Sufi has presented an answer to that one. And that is what say, here it is. I copied it from the internet. Actually, Mansoor al-Hallaaj, a figure much reverenced by Sufis, said, "I am he with capital H, whom I love." He exclaimed, "He whom I love is I." That means there is no difference but him and myself. I have become, we are merged together. We are two souls co-inhabiting one body. That means that's why Jesus said, "Me and my Father are one." So that's what the Sufis say. If you see me, you see him Allah. And if you see Allah, you see me. Al-Hanak, that's what the Shah Shams Tabri is also proclaimed. And the mullahs killed him and they took his skin off. That Allah has no son. And same are the thing going on in temple high priest, temple practice. When Jesus proclaimed in the temple that he is the Messiah, then the temple priest and other people said, we won't kill you for breaking the Sabbath, but for proclaiming that you are the son of the Most High Elohim, we must kill you. So that's what these Mohammedan are. They are legacy of those Messianic Jews, or those Jewish people. And this kosher is halal, and Allah has no son, and all this, the prayer and other things, you know, and fasting, everything come from the temple practices. So this sunnah, or the circumcision, is also what they were doing in the temple, catching strangers and slaves, and they were circumcising them and making them sons of Abraham. Because when in Abraham had two sons, one was Ishmael, the other was Isaac. When Ishmael was born, Abraham did not circumcise him. But when Isaac was born, his real son, then he circumcised him, he circumcised himself. And this circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac, which only the Semitic seed of Isaac can have it, nobody else. So today you see white Jews, you know, European Jews and all that, they are all fake ones. That is what Angel Stephen, not Saint, you know, Angel Stephen, he was the administrator of the Church of God, and he was baptizing Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham. And the temple priest did not like it, because he was making Jew inwardly, not of the physical body. And they wanted to make Jew of circumcision and rituals. And today you have many people being done like that. So people complained against Angel Stephen. So he was called to the temple to explain. And he went there, he told them, look, our forefather Abraham was a noble man. Don't make fake sons of Abraham. And the temple over there in its Sanhedrin members, who were stooges of the temple high priest, they were grinding their teeth that this man is exposing our hypocrisy. Let us kill him. He's stifling our business. We want to make money, and he's stopping us to make the fake Jews. Fake sons of Isaac. So they killed him, you know. And Saul was the one who overlooked the killing. And Angel Stephen was praying, Father, forgive them, they don't know what they are doing. And Saul told them, hey, look, he's praying for you, don't kill him. But they won't listen to Saul. They killed him, you know. So today you see many Jews who are white, not Semitic race, Aryan race, European races, or other people, you know, black one also. They are not Semitic, Negro race. They are circumcised. And they are not sons of Isaac. They are not Semitic sons, and they are going to kill them. When they entered the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, Hazrat Muhammad Sahib told them that when you see a Jew, kill him. Because they were very cruel people. They were killing apostles by throwing them before the animals to be eaten alive. But soon they entered the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib humbly, and then they started their temple practices. So halal is kosher, and then this circumcision, which made them the sons of Isaac. So people in India, Pakistan, they are Aryan race, nothing to do with Semitic race. And they are the fake sons of Isaac and Abraham. So these fake sons were created by the temple priest for the sake of money, and Stephen, angel Stephen, he told them to not do it, stop it, these malpractice. That our forefather Abraham was a nobleman, don't make fake sons of Abraham. And they are the one who came them today. So they created their own enemies. And that is what the second coming of Jesus said, Nanak, do not blame a third party, blame yourself for the crop you have sown. Whatever you have sown, so shall you reap. So if you have sown something, you will reap it too. So they have sown the fake sons of Isaac through circumcision. And now they will reap the fruit of that fake sons from India, Pakistan, Iran. And they are the one number one enemy of Israel. And they will kill them. So the gospel is for those who are solitary. If you are not solitary, you can't enter it through the narrow gate that leads to the royal vineyard of our Father, which is this one. Which is the royal vineyard of our Father. Here John the Baptist baptized them in the name of Abraham, and he baptized Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father, Yahweh. And that's why his name was Yeshua, made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam. Jesus was the second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother of Jesus. And he is holding scripture. Jesus is not holding any scripture. So scripture, law and scripture, law and prophets were till John the Baptist, Luke 16 verse 16. And afterward no law, no prophet, but he opened the gate to this royal kingdom of God, in which you need to be solitary and twice born. Twice born means our Father is the Allah, Elohim, Parbrahm, same thing. And the true vine is planted by Allah, Parbrahm, Elohim in his vineyard. And you need to enter this one, burn your ego, and then graft yourself to this true vine to suck your daily bread of life. Take it to your heart, digest it with the teeth of logical reasoning to view logo, and then you preach gospel through your own heart, logo, explaining people from the very basic. And that is, those people who do it, they are not Christian, they are Christ, the primary source of light. As our anointed elder brother was. So we are not people of the book. We are people of Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is common sense. Holy Spirit shatters the fetters of the dead letters of the holy books. You can make corruption with the knowledge of Holy Spirit. You can correct it and put it right. So the holes can be done with the knowledge of Holy Spirit, and then make the things whole. Jesus came to fulfill the law and not to destroy it. So with this introduction, I will leave it, that in Jesus, the gospel you get is direct from our supernatural Father. Nobody can give you. Jesus could not give gospel to Peter, who was once born. That's why at the Last Supper, when Jesus took them into the house of our Father, he started washing their feet, which the Pharisee Simon did not do it, to honor Jesus. And when he came to Peter, Peter said, "You wash my head also." First he refused because, "Yeah, my rabbi, he's going to wash my feet? No, no, no. We have to serve him. Jesus came to serve us and not to be served." So when Jesus told him, "Unless I wash your feet, you are not part of me," then he said, "Okay, do it. Then wash my head also so I can have gospel." Jesus said, "You are already clean because your heart is clean. You speak what is in your heart, like a little child. Like a little child, whatever you have in the heart, you say it. You don't keep anything secret in your heart." So that is the narrow gate that leads to the royal kingdom of God, which is the vineyard of our Father, and where we work and we grace and we come out and preach gospel. Our Father, our supernatural Father, Allah, Parbrahm, Elohim, bless you.